The chaotic, dysfunctional evacuation of Kabul last summer was clear for all to see. Desperate Afghans, some waving British passports, locked out of the British embassy, left behind as the final flights lifted to safety. Now a whistleblower claims it was chaos and dysfunction too inside the UK Foreign Office that led to some they failed to help being murdered by the Taliban. Now in South London, Kasim finally escaped Afghanistan last week after spending months stuck in Kabul with his two children and pregnant wife, trying to contact the British government. His family are still there and he's hiding his identity for fear of Taliban reprisals.
Because they did not respond to our emails at all. How will they will come and they will protect us? At least you respond to our email, give us some hope to that we understand that, okay, the government is doing something about us.
In damning new evidence, Raphael Marshall, a senior desk officer at the Foreign Office, claims thousands of emails from desperate Afghans were not read. On key days, the majority of team members were working from home and were not required to work weekends and nights. No members of staff had a detailed knowledge of Afghanistan or spoke any Afghan languages. And of the 150,000 people who contacted them, he says fewer than 5% received assistance. Did Afghans die because people were working from home and not answering emails?
I don't accept that. We secured the evacuation of 15,000 people in just 2 weeks. The biggest operation in living memory, more than any other country with the exception of the US.
What lessons have you learned from this?
I think it's always easy, with the benefit of hindsight, to come back and say things should have been done differently.
Okay, with the benefit of hindsight, what lessons have you learned?
Well, look, there's all sorts of things that you can look back on. I've already said that with the benefit of hindsight, I wouldn't have gone away.
Dominic Raab was on holiday when Kabul fell. So too was the civil servant in charge of the Foreign Office, Sir Philip Barton, who today admitted to MPs he actually stayed on holiday for a further 11 days.
There's a lesson for me in all of this, which I accept. And if I had my time again, I would have come back. I would have come back earlier.
Questions too for Boris Johnson. Tonight this letter has emerged from his parliamentary aide confirming a chartered flight of animals from Afghanistan to Britain could go ahead back in August. Earlier in the day, the PM denied he'd ever intervened to make it happen. 4 months on from the fall of Kabul, the fallout very much continues. Daniel Hewitt, News at 10.